Hey, what's up? Cholo Tolentino here, and congratulations to the Critics Hub for 200 weeks of reviewing all the latest anime. So yeah, keep it up, enjoy the journey, and love seeing your content.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Critics Hub.
Let's now talk about Sakuna Episode 8! 200 weeks of the Critics Hub, guys! And this is the first time we're going to review this anime! So, let's get down to business. Pace! The pacing eh, medyo... medyo tense. The moment Sakuna stood away, do I have complaints? Wala! Right? Although it was tense, meron ding... meron din mga comic moments, may mga light-hearted moments until the big reveal on who was mixing that substance into the rice. It just kept the pacing tense. Right? So no complaints about the pacing of this episode, guys. Talagang we got a great setup here for the road to the finale. Tandaan nyo, Sakuna is only I think it's only 12 episodes long. So, kung kakalkulahin natin, this episode starts the road to the finale. And we got a swell pacing here. No naman, first gear shift was when an old friend visited Tama. If you ask me, this is the gear shift that triggered the entire episode. Alright, obvious. It's the obvious trigger to the entire episode. No brainer, guys. Second gear shift was when Sakura discovered something in the Tamahoho. Yun nga yung substance na nandun sa rice na yun. Basically, what does this gear shift tell us? What? Eh, the main protag's maturity. Alright? So, nothing gets past, no rice gets past her na. This is a clear sign na talagang nagagampanan na niya yung kanyang pagiging harvest goddess. Yung amoy, tingin, at yung pakiramdam niya towards rice, it's that impeccable na. You can just simply cheer on. You can just simply cheer the main protag on from here on and then. Talagang galap na siyang harvest goddess. Final gear shift. Alright. Tatlo. Was when Sakuna finally found who the culprit is. Yung naghahalo ng substance sa rice. What does this gear shift tell? Simple lang. It's another sign that despite dutifully carrying out her duties as the harvest goddess, hindi pa rin siya nakakalimot sa kaibigan. Kahit gulangan pa siya nito, kaibigan pa rin ang turo niya kay Kurokoa. Pero guys, will it be enough for you to totally understand what happened in this episode? Toto. Right? Kahit isumbat ko sa inyo araw-araw, I would do it. Because skipping a few sequences in an episode, no, doesn't work that way. Watch the episode from start to finish. That's the only way you would either appreciate or at least understand an episode. Don't just limit yourself to these three gear shifts. Gear shifts only serve as markers in an episode. Okay? Ako, in my case, para matandaan ko kung anong episode yung kung saan ikinikwento sa akin. Right? Because these are the three sequences that made a mark in my brain. That really picked my brain. story sequence dito, pero merong bago. Courtesy of Sakuna herself. Therefore, planchado ang plot, guys! Munti ko nang sabihin! Malinis eh! Pero naalala ko na those two backstory sequences weren't explainer material. Right? They just enhanced the current frame of mind Sakuna has on how she treats Kokoroa as a friend. Right? Kung gano'n niya ituring ito na beshi waps, right? Na kasi mag-BFF na kasi sila since childhood. Although technically they're still kids. Saliit nila. But nonetheless, it's a well ironed out plot. Those backstory sequences were in their proper places. Okay? But I'm sorry guys. They are still backstory sequences. They're not explainer material. Okay? So iron out ang plot na to. Well ironed out. Let's be clear on that. So base, flow, and plot all came together and well, I can therefore say that this anime is on probably one of the wildest roads to the finale we're going to see this season.